I've been trying to relax a bit. I'm not very good at relaxing. I took the opportunity when I moved into the house to buy myself some new pyjamas. I normally save that luxury for Christmas. Does anybody else get new pyjamas at Christmas?
Yeah.
So I brought it forward by a month when I moved into the house and I went off to Marks and Spencer's. I don't know if you know this, but Marks and Spencer's don't really sell pyjamas anymore. They sell stay-at-home leisure wear. So I looked them on the hanger and I thought they looked like pyjamas. So I bought them anyway, I took them home, I put them on straight away and I thought they feel like pyjamas. And I thought this is just Marks and Spencer's being overly fancy with the naming of things, that's all it is. And I thought what would be the difference between pyjamas and something called stay-at-home leisure wear anyway. And then I went to do the dishes, I stood in front of the kitchen sink and I went to roll my sleeves up and the cuffs on the stay-at-home leisure wear were so tight that I couldn't roll my sleeves up. So I couldn't do the dishes. And I like to think that was Marks and Spencer's going, hey you, sit yourself down. But then he looked, the 90s will be flammable and I'll get out the fucking cooking and all. But I think you can't be too relaxed. I think it's possible to be too relaxed because I think the filter that's between your brain and your mouth is there for a reason. I went for massages with a friend of mine. We came out afterwards, got in the car to go home. I was driving, she was in the passenger seat. We were both so floppy and relaxed after the massages that neither of us spoke for ages. It was really comfortable, a proper comfortable silence, if you like. I was just concentrating on the driving. She was watching the scenery go by out of the window. It was lovely. 20 minutes we were like that. 20 minutes of complete silence. She chose to break the 20-minute silence with this sentence. I tell you who else is a bad driver. I've got a bit of pop trivia for you, might not know this. You know Rihanna? Yeah. She has insured her legs for $1 million. And I don't really know why, because I'm pretty sure she's a singer, yes?
Yes,
thank you. And I'm almost certain you can do that sitting down. I mean, her legs aren't proper anyway. They don't meet at the top or anything. My mum would say about her, she couldn't stop a pig in an alleyway. Just for the record, I could totally stop a pig in an alleyway. Stop it, stun it, put it in me fucking freezer. Only a few weeks ago, my fella said to me, he said, your day-to-day is busier than mine. He said, do you want me to go and do a quick food shop? And I said, oh, that would be amazing, thanks very much. I said, I'm only here for a couple of days, so don't get loads in. He said, just give us a list. So I said, great. So I made him a list, off he went. When he came back in, he said, I managed to get everything off the list apart from one thing. I said, that's great, thanks very much. I started to unpack the bags, put them in the cupboard. And I said, what was the thing you didn't manage to get? He said, I didn't manage to get you any avocados. I said, oh, that's all right, don't worry about that. He said, so I bought you some pork pies instead. I wish you worked for Tesco Home Delivery. We've run out of celery, so we've given you a Swiss roll. But he said the best thing about them, he said, they're whoops pork pies. I said, I don't know what that means. He said, they're whoops pork pies. He said, they're gonna run out. We'll have to eat all six of them before we go to bed. Yes. You know those cookie shops on the high street where you can get the normal sized cookies, but you can also get the bigger sort of celebration ones. He bought me one of those celebration one a few years ago for part of my Christmas present, and it was smashing. I was unexpected. It was great. And I opened the box and I said, this is a great present. This is excellent. He said, oh, I'm glad you like it. It was all iced Merry Christmas, Sarah, with kisses on. He said, I'm glad you like it. He said, there's only one drawback. And I'm looking at a cookie that's bigger than me head thinking, there's no fucking drawback. He said, there's only one drawback, it only lasts 5 days. I said, it's like you don't know me at all. He said, you didn't let me finish, it only lasts 5 days, and I bought it 4 days ago. He said, stop your fucking chatting and get the kettle on then. But when I lived alone, I really liked it. I really liked living alone. But one of the things I love about living with somebody else again is I like the unpredictability of it. I like that every now and again, a sentence will come out that I would never have said. The most recent one, out of nowhere, he just went, your shed's no good to have a wank in. And I said, That's because it's a greenhouse, love. My family are hilarious. It's very good. We all know that it's good to laugh. It is good to laugh when you're with your friends or your family. We all know laughing does you good because it's medically proven to do you good, isn't it? It's medically proven to do you good because it gets all of your dolphins out. And you don't want them cooped up, do you? No. It's just cruel. But I'm lucky that I have very funny friends and family. And when I'm with my friends, it's amazing. So one of them will say something funny, somebody tops and I top, and it goes up and up and up and up, and it's great. But I've noticed recently one of my friends isn't really playing the game, and every time he says something, the whole lot comes crashing down and turns to shit. So what I do now, just before he says anything at all, I just go, bank. Actually, as an aside, I should tell you this. I did recently treat myself to a new... and I cannot recommend it highly enough. It's only got the one speed, which I think a lot of people in this room would be like, one speed, that sounds rubbish. You know what the speed is? Fucking hell yes, that's the speed. Any vibrator that needs a square battery is already fine by me. But the problem, if you can call it that, the problem with it being so fast and efficient is that I can't... Can't always get a scenario going in me head. Do you know what I mean? Do you know what I mean?
You know what I fucking mean.
Because normally, I'd be like this. Not out loud, I don't do it out loud. I'm just doing it for you. But normally I'd be like this. He walks in the room. He's wearing a suit. I like him to have a job, there's nothing wrong with that. But with the new one, it's much more like this. There's a knock at the done. I tell you what it is. What it actually is an electric toothbrush with a special end. Just feel the need to share it with you. The information. I didn't bring it with us.
Just work it along the aisles, girls.
But even though it's a toothbrush, I don't use it as a toothbrush because I'm nervous because I get the ends mixed up. And accidentally take all the plaque off me nunny. But according to women's magazines, there are only two options for hair down there for women. The options are all off or most off. Give us a cheer if you think all off is the way to go. Yay! Is that a filler in the middle of that there? Technically aimed at you, love. I suppose it is good to know we've got a paedophile in. That's what it means. That's what it means. Gives it to you if you think more stuff is the way to go. Yeah. Still quite a lot of you left, isn't there? Can only assume that the rest of you are like me. I just try to keep it in me pants. Even if sometimes that involves tucking it in. But surely the most ridiculous of all of the things we are supposed to do to ourselves is anal bleaching. Now, some of you might not know what that is. If you don't know what it is, it's exactly as it sounds. Some people, and I don't know why, I can't answer that question for you. Some people choose to have their arseholes bleached. As far as I'm concerned, regardless of your gender, regardless of your sexuality, if somebody is so close to your arsehole that they can see the colour of it, they're not going to stop. This is never going to happen. Smack. Smack.
Oh, sorry, love, I don't do that colour.
It's warm now, isn't it?
it's Sarah Millican here. Please make sure you subscribe to my channel to stay up to date with all of my latest videos. Don't forget to like, pop a comment below, and why not stick around to watch a few more? I'm sure those emails or those dishes can wait a bit longer.